हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज समीरन मेहती, सीनियर लेक्चरर इन कंप्यूटर इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट फ्रॉम प्रवीण पाटिल पॉलिटेक्निक। आई होप यू हैव वॉच चैप्टर नंबर 4 पार्ट 1। आई एम टुडे हियर विद चैप्टर नंबर 4 पार्ट 2 व्हिच इज़ द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 4। सो वी वर डिस्कसिंग नेटवर्क कनेक्टिंग डिवाइसेज। सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ नेटवर्क कनेक्टिंग डिवाइसेज, स्टार्टिंग विद द हब। हब इज़ इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज इट ब्रॉडकास्ट डेटा फ्रॉम वन पोर्ट टू ऑल अदर पोर्ट्स इन द नेटवर्क। दिस इज एन इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ हब, इन डिटेल विल डिस्कस इन द अपकमिंग स्लाइड्स। रिपीटर्स आर नथिंग बट यूज इन प्लेसेज वेयर एम्प्लीफिकेशन ऑफ इनपुट सिग्नल इज नेसेसरी, इन द सेंस वेयर अ डेटा यू नो एनर्जी लॉस टेक्स प्लेस, राइट? सो देयर एम्प्लीफिकेशन शुड बी प्रोवाइडेड, सो दैट इज वेयर रिपीटर्स आर यूज्ड। Routers is one of the most important network connecting devices we have. When there are more than one computer at home and you have a single internet connection, you need a router. A router is a device which is used when multiple devices need to connect to the internet using same IP. So this is really important. Fine. Regarding gateway, gateway and router, you know, they both connect, you know, they both help us to connect to an internet, but router works with a similar network, whereas gateway works with a different network. So gateway is used when two different network topologies are being used, for example bus N star or bus N ring. They act as a translator switch intelligent device which sends data to a particular port, and this is how gateway is different from router. Bridge has same function as switch but much more primitive and has lesser parts, or I could say lesser ports. So switch and bridge, you know, works in a similar fashion, but you know, bridge is much more traditional, and you know, switch is much more you know, modern, I could say. Then we have NICs, and I hope you have seen NIC in a motherboard, and it is very important component installed in a computer which is responsible for connecting a particular computer to a network. So this is the diagram of hub, USB hub and 4-port hub. There are three types of hub. Active hub, as the name suggests, active hub is a hub which can amplify or regenerate the information signal. This type of hub has an advantage as it also amplifies the incoming signal as well as forward it to multiple devices. So it amplifies as well as forward it to more than one devices. This hub is known as multi-port repeater, because multi-ports in the sense, because it is sending data to more than one port or more than one device. Passive hub works like a simple bridge. It is just used for creating a connection between various devices. And remember students, passive hub does not have the ability to amplify or regenerate any incoming signal. It receives signals and accordingly forwards it. So this is the major difference between active and passive. Whereas in active we have you know, amplification, but in passive we don't have amplification. And what is intelligent hub? It can perform task of both active and passive, in the sense it increases the speed and effectiveness of total network, thus making the performance powerful, right? And it also helps in troubleshooting the problems. So this is why it is known as intelligent hub. Then we have a switch. I hope you guys have you know, seen switch in our computer labs, because you know, there are various devices connected you know, to each other via a LAN, via a switch, fine? So this is nothing but a switch. So difference between hub and switch, to connect a network of personal computers together, they can be joined through a central hub, but in case if multiple devices are required to be connected with the help of LAN or VLAN, then we could go for a switch. Hub is less expensive, whereas switch is more expensive, and accordingly hub is less intelligent, switch is more intelligent. Hub is a passive device, which is an active device. It sends the received packet to all ports, and it only sends packets to only destination ports. So this is why it is much more intelligent. It uses broadcast technology, that is one to all. It uses point to point technology, that is one to one, and it is cheaper in cost, it is higher in cost. A router, so a network router is a network control device with interfaces in multiple networks whose task is to copy packet or data from one network to another. A router gives path to data packet to destination. A router provides connectivity inside enterprises, between enterprises and the internet, and within an internet service provider. I hope the point is clear. So this is our OSI layer. PDNT SPA, that is physical data network transport session presentation application, right? And router works in network layer, so accordingly only 1, 2, and 3 are given, that is it is related to physical data and network only, fine. And device A, that is working as a sender, and device B is working as a receiver. So device A is sending a packet or a data to a router via network, and accordingly that router with the help of another network is sending a packet to the receiver, that is device B. Types of routers, we have static routers and dynamic routers. This router is hard coded in the routing table. The administrator has no configuration, hence he needs to set up all routes manually. And static routing is the process of defining route paths across data networks and can be used to conserve LAN and WAN bandwidth and optimize processing time. So for example, if I need to send data to 4 devices or 10 devices connected to a LAN, so I have to type each of the 10 IPs as far as static routing is concerned. But that is not the case regarding dynamic routers. Only the first route has to be manually confirmed and all other routes are additionally automatically discovered. So this is the power of dynamic routing. And static routing is good for small networks where there are 5 to 10 devices, because manually an administrator has to type IP addresses for the same. But as far as big networks are concerned, hundreds, thousands of devices are need to be connected, then dynamic routers are a must. Advantage of routers, it provides high network fault tolerance through redundant components and provides WAN network as well, that is internet. Disadvantage of router is more expensive than hub, bridge and switch, and they require considerable amount of initial configuration. So repeater is an electronic device that basically amplifies or regenerates a signal in case of attenuation or loss of energy, and it operates on physical layer of OSI model, that is the first layer. And repeater is regenerator and not an amplifier. An amplifier cannot discriminate between intended signal and noise. It amplifies everything fed to it. So basically, technically speaking, a repeater is not an amplifier, because it can tell what is a noise and what is a data, but amplifier cannot. So repeater is regenerator and not an amplifier, a point to be noted, students. So repeater connected with different LANs. So LAN number 1, LAN number 2 is connected via repeater, and LAN number 1 is connected to LAN number 3 via again a repeater. Types of repeater: amplifier, which simply amplifies or multiplies an incoming signal along with a noise. And signal regenerating, it amplifies only data signals and does not amplify noise signals. So signal regenerating is the much more intelligent repeater, we can say. Advantage of repeater are they passes all traffic in bi-directions. Repeaters can reduce the effect of noise using signal regenerating type of repeaters. Repeaters can extend the network. Disadvantage of repeater, they do not examine any destination address and they do not filter or transmit any data. Big problem with repeater: if the network traffic is heavy, then repeater is not feasible. Gateway works at all the 7 layers of OSI model. Gateway is a network device which interconnects 2 heterogeneous networks. So point to be noted, students, if there are 2 heterogeneous networks, that is 2 different networks, then gateway is a must where routers won't be feasible. Gateway is a connectivity link between 2 networks that uses dissimilar, that is different protocols and architecture. And a gateway is a network element that acts as an entrance point to another network. If you could see, this is a star network and this is a bus network. So we have 2 different networks, heterogeneous network, where to combine these 2 networks, we require a gateway. Working of gateway, the figure shows the working of a gateway. Consider 2 networks, say in Pune, and a network is in Mumbai, right? If data has to be sent from one place to another, we need to ensure that the network topologies that are being used by both the networks are same. If not, then we need to use a gateway. A gateway is a node in a computer network, a key stopping point for data on its way to form other networks. Advantage of gateway: used to expand the network, and gateway is a server, so it provides some security, effectively handles the traffic problems. And disadvantage of gateway are slow and it never filters out data. So these are some of the problems as far as gateway is concerned. Regarding modem is nothing but modulation and demodulation. I hope everyone knows what is a modem. It is a hardware component that allows a computer such as router or switch to connect to the internet. So, you know, a modem is required to be connected to an internet. A modem acts as a sort of translator. It allows detailed data to be transmitted over analog signals of transmission such as telephone line. So try to understand, students, if I want to send some data, right? So my data will be in a detailed format in my processor or in my system, right? But it has to be passed to some other device via airways, or I could say via a telephone line. But unfortunately, telephone line cannot handle digital data, but it can handle analog data. So there has to be a mechanism where a digital data from a device must be translated to analog signals, because telephone lines are able to handle only analog signals, right? So this process of conversion of digital to analog, that is from device to telephone lines, is known as modulation. This is at the sender side. But at the receiver side, from telephone line again back to device, in telephone line we have analog signal, in device we should have digital signal. So again, analog to digital conversion must take place. That is nothing but demodulation. So this is the major purpose of modem. Modem stands for modulation and demodulation. Modulation means digital to analog, from device to telephone signals, and again at the receiver side, from telephone to device, that is analog to digital, that is nothing but demodulation. So this is the crux of modem. I hope the point is clear as far as modem is concerned. In case of doubts, you could post a comment in Google Classroom, or we have live sessions, then you could clarify your doubts. So this is the diagram of modem, from device to telephone line. Digital to analog must be done. So we have a modem, that is modulation, and from analog to digital, that is from telephone lines to devices or the receiver, I could say, then analog to digital must be converted. So that is nothing but demodulation. So modem, make sure modulation and demodulation takes place. This was it regarding chapter number 4. I'll soon upload chapter number 5. Till then, take care. Bye.